Why is it that bank examinations have become so difficult to crack? जितना जल्दी आप ये समझ जाएंगे कि इस difficulty का reason क्या है, उतना जल्दी ही आप इन examinations को clear कर पाएंगे. In English, the faster you understand the major reason behind the difficulty in cracking these exams, the faster you can crack it. There are three major reasons behind the difficulty level of these examinations. The increasing difficulty level. The first reason is the increasing competition and the success ratio, जिसके बारे में briefly बात करेंगे. The second reason is teachers. How are teachers responsible for making these bank examinations so difficult or so tough to crack? And the third is students. आपका onus क्या है? What is your onus? What is your responsibility which is not being fulfilled? What is my responsibility as a teacher which is not being fulfilled? And what is the competition? What is the exact level of competition? ये तीन reasons हैं which combine the reasoning for the increasing difficulty of bank exams. So let's start with point number one, which is competition. If you see at RBI, around 2 lakh people sit for the examination every year, 2 lakh students. And on an average, the number of seats are around 200. So around 200 students for 2 lakh aspirants. That means a success ratio of 0.1%. It is too less when we actually carry out the mathematics behind it. Unsurprisingly and unfortunately, the ratio remains the same for IBPS, SBI, as well as for UPSC. IBPS ki baat karein, toh there are around 50 lakh students who sit for IBPS and SBI together on an average every year, and the average number of seats are about 5,000. Similarly, in UPSC, the average number of seats we can take to be about 1,000, and about 10 lakh plus students sit for the examination every year. Again, the ratio comes out to be 0.1%. This reminds me of a conversation I had with one of my very old friends who was working in one of the big fours at that time. And I was preparing for UPSC, and the first question she asked me was, what is the success ratio? Surprisingly, I had never thought about the success ratio before jumping into UPSC and these examinations at that time. So we calculated it, and I was surprised to realize it that it is 0.1%. It was the same at that time as well. And she told me that she's never going to sit for any examination like this, just because the examination that she had cleared had a success ratio of about 50%, and it was difficult for her. That ratio was also difficult for her. So aap soch sakte ho ki competition hai. There are too little seats and too many students, too many aspirants aspiring to be bank employees, aspiring to join RBI, aspiring to join SBI, trying to join UPSC or crack civil services examination. Bahut sare aspirants hain, bahut kam seats hain. So competition is obvious. But the other two reasons are more important, which can reduce the competition that you face in the actual examination. These two reasons are the responsibility of teachers, which is not being met, and the responsibility on the part of students. Let's start discussing them one by one. So, sabse pehle start karte hain teachers se. Let's start with teachers. Aisi kya problem hai? What is the underlying problem and the reason for the problem that teachers are not able to help you crack these examinations in your first attempt itself? There are various reasons. Sabse pehla jo reason hai, the first reason is that you have to start looking for experts. One teacher can only be an expert in one individual area. For example, I can say very confidently that I'm an expert in the field of finance management and economic and social issues for RBI. मुझे इंडियन इकोनॉमी समझ आती है, आई बीन रीडिंग इट सिंस माई ग्रेजुएशन डेज और इवन बिफोर दैट इन माई 11th एंड 12th ऑल्सो आई हैड इंडियन इकोनॉमी एंड आई हैव बीन रीडिंग फाइनेंस एंड मैनेजमेंट सिंस माई ग्रेजुएशन डेज सो आई अंडरस्टैंड दीज थ्री एरियाज आई बीन रीडिंग इट आई बीन स्टडिंग दीज एरियाज स्टडिंग दीज सब्जेक्ट फॉर द पास्ट प्रॉब्ली 6-7 ईयर्स इफ आई रिमूव द टीचिंग पार्ट ओके So I can say confidently that because I have internalized the various concepts, I have read these concepts multiple times, so I'm an expert in these areas. I can explain it well. I can answer your questions. The same does not happen everywhere. A very popular example is
मैथ्स क्वांट्स एंड रीजनिंग. आप देखोगे द सेम टीचर इज टीचिंग क्वांट फॉर आरबीआई और बैंकिंग, द सेम टीचर इज टीचिंग क्वांट फॉर एसएससी, द सेम टीचर इज टीचिंग क्वांट फॉर सीसैट, द सेम टीचर इज टीचिंग क्वांट फॉर एनी अदर एग्जामिनेशन. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज द डिमांड इज डिफरेंट बट द सेम टीचर because he understand only one of those areas, he's replicating the same strategy in all the exams. And we saw that failure in this year's RBI examination. What happened in the exam was, the level was according to CAT examination, but students were prepared according to banking examination. And that resulted in failure of a lot of students. They panicked, or they could not clear the examination, or they could not even attempt good number of questions even after a very good preparation. So what is the result? The result is, or the conclusion of this discussion is, look for experts. Don't run after popular teachers just because they are popular. Look for their expertise. Okay. The second major reason, and it is a responsibility of us as well as a responsibility of the consumer of the content, which is the student, is to not get into the trap of Telegram marketing. Telegram mein aap dekhoge so many fake accounts. Every day I receive probably 15-20 messages on Telegram from fake accounts. Bahut ajeeb ajeeb se messages aate hain, sare fake numbers hote hain. At times I cannot even identify whether the number is fake or real, but with the messages it becomes clear over time. In fact, porn bhi bahut sari aati hai fake accounts ke through. So these kind of activities are happening on Telegram. So it is only wise not to believe something as soon as it is said. Aisa nahi hai ki kisi student ne bola and you believe it outrightly, thinking that the student is correct. The student might be fake as well. He might be genuine, but he might also be fake. So it is very close to fake news paralysis that we are facing in the Indian and global political system also. Same problem yahan par bhi dikh rahi hai. There are a lot of fake informations available, a lot of fake criticism, a lot of genuine criticism at the same time, a lot of fake, praising of a lot of institutes and teachers. So that is a major problem. So I would highly recommend that you stop believing all those news and, judge a teacher yourself. Now, how do you do that? The best method is, go to YouTube, ask the teacher for his YouTube videos and just see how the teacher teaches. What is the conceptual clarity of the teacher? Okay. How good or bad he is at explaining something. Is he just reading out from the PDFs, or is he able to explain by using a whiteboard, or is he able to, understand and remember those concepts himself as well, or is he just reading it out? So, wo sara filtration aapko karna padega. You have to do that. The easiest method, as I said, is YouTube. Okay. The fourth major point is conceptual clarity. Now I'm coming to quant and reasoning again. I see a lot of students every year run after tricks and shortcuts in studying, especially quant and reasoning, if not other subjects. Please don't run after short tricks. I have been saying the same thing for the last 3 years, ki bhai universal applicability wale jo rules and regulations hai, please read those. And we saw that happening in this year's RBI examination. The paper was so difficult, it was CAT level. All those shortcuts and tricks failed in the face of a lot of students. What succeeded was conceptual clarity. Always look for conceptual clarity. Time aapke paas bahut hai to prepare for these examinations. Samay ki problem nahi hai. Problem hai attitude ki. If you go with the right attitude that I have to understand concept first rather than trying to solve it as fast as possible, you will always be successful. Let us now come to the third major reason of why bank exams are so difficult to crack. The reason is the onus of students. Ab yahan main aapko blame nahin kar raha hoon, but I want to highlight the problems that students of India face because of the Indian education system. The first major problem with our students is that we are not taught how to study. We are always taught in schools and colleges what is to be studied and why are we studying it. We are studying it always to get maximum marks, kyunki jitne zyada number honge utna zyada scope hamara badh jayega to enter a good institute. We are always running after institutes and colleges and a good job with an MNC and so on and so forth. Okay. In fact, we are always running after proving something to the society. Ab us hoard mein kya hota hai? We are always focused upon the short-term reason of why are we studying. Numbers zyada lane hain. And we are always focused on what is to be studied. Kya padhna hai? Ye book puri rat leni hai. Ye kitab mein jitna bhi kuch likha hua hai, sare facts and figures, you should be able to remember it and recall it or exam mein ulti karke aana hai. So, we are never taught how to study. This is what I'm going to be focusing upon in the next 1 year very comprehensively. I want to teach my students and every student in the entire country how we should be studying. Bakwas ki baat na karke, we will keep focusing upon how you can learn to study better, to study smart, to organize yourself. Okay? So, whether it is creating a daily planner, whether it is following a daily planner, whether it is creating a method to make your notes, a very scientific method on creating notes, whether it is reducing your exposure to mobiles and increasing your exposure to laptops, whether it is knowing where to make, when to make notes on paper and when to make notes on laptop, all these things we're going to talk about one by one. So how to make notes, how to study, that is a big problem. The faster you realize this problem, the faster you can find its solution. The second major problem that students in India specifically face is revision. Hame school mein ya college mein kabhi bhi nahi padhaya gaya, kabhi bhi nahi sikhaya gaya. We are never taught, we are never made to identify the importance of regular revision. Exam se 2 din pehle, 3 din pehle padh lete the. Exam mein rat ke chale gaye, we just clear the examination. That's how the education system has been working for majority of us. Kuch smart students hote the who are the front benches, but majority of us are not amongst them. So we are never taught the importance of revision, and we are also not taught how to revise. So the second major problem is regular revision. The importance, the method, and how you can use revision to increase your chances of getting selected in your first attempt itself. So, ये मैं आपको बताऊंगा अपनी classes के through. धीरे-धीरे हम लोग YouTube पे start करेंगे how to revise better. And this is a major problem why students are unable to clear the exam. The third major problem is distractions. We have so many distractions in our lives nowadays. Whether it is Instagram, whether it is Facebook, Telegram is a major distraction. That they are affecting our studies to a major scale and we don't identify it. I can say it from my personal perspective. Main agar 2 din acche se phone use kar leta hoon, whether I'm taking calls of students, whether I'm talking to my team too much. If I'm using my phone too much, I get addicted to it instantly. And I can see in the mirror myself the impact that it has on my productivity. And the fourth and the most important reason that is affecting students' ability to clear these exams is too much material but too little information. Material hum bahut zyada collect kar lete hain. We have a habit of accumulating and holding a lot of material, but we are able to utilize only a small portion of that material for our studies. So material to humne collect kar liya, we are unable to convert that material into information. Why? Because the amount of material that we have collected is just too much. Too many sources. Ek book bhi le li NCERT, Ramesh Singh bhi khareed li, Dattan Sundaram bhi khareed li, Mishran Puri bhi khareed li, Umma Kapila bhi khareed liya, Anu Jindal ka course bhi le liya, koi aur course bhi le liya, and now you're confused what to do, what to study and what not to study. So stick to one source. Identify one source for yourself which fits for you and then just stick to it. Don't try and juggle between different sources again and again. आप अपनी anxiety बढ़ा रहे हो, अपना pressure बढ़ा रहे हो, and it will affect your performance also. Okay? So with these major reasons, I'm very very certain कि कुछ ना कुछ students के पास better information जाएगी and they'll be able to work on their weaknesses and strengthen their strengths further. Okay? With this, I call this session, this small video off. If you really like what I discuss and how I approach different banking examinations and UPSC, certain UPSC options, then do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Press that small bell icon that gives me a kick to keep teaching, to keep discussing the major problems that you face and how to overcome these problems. All the best, guys. Bye-bye.